Hi, in continuity to my last video in which I have explained the concept and accounting process for bank sub-ledger in SAP S4 HANA, the link is shared in the screen or even you can find it in the description. In this video, I will perform the posting for bank outgoing and incoming payment in SAP S4 HANA. So if you are interested, please stay connected and watch this video till the end. Hi, my name is Mohammed Mazammil Khan and I publish video regarding the SAP S4 HANA. So if you are interested, kindly subscribe my channel and stay updated with the latest and upcoming videos. Hi, in today's video, I will perform the following transaction in sequence. First, I will show you the report for vendor and customer open item for payments using transaction code FBl1N and FBL5N. After that, I'll perform the bank incoming payment and the transaction code used is F-28. The last is the posting of bank outgoing payment using T code F-53. Now first I will show you the vendor open invoices and the T code is FBL1N. Now in this screen, enter your vendor number, then company code and select the open item and provide the key date, which is by default the current date. Now execute the report. Here in this report you can see the open invoices which are not paid yet for vendor, and right now we can see there is only one open invoice for this vendor, which is of amount 1000. Now go back to SAP main menu using T code /N. Now enter the T code FBL5N to check the open invoices for customer. Now here in this screen, enter the customer number first, then your company code, which is 2000, and maintain the open item check and provide the open at key date, which is your current date, and execute the report. Now this report shows you the open invoices for the customer. As you can see here that there is only one invoice for this customer of amount 1000. Now go back to SAP menu using the T code /N. Now the second part is to post the incoming payment, and T code used is F-28. Now in this section, enter the document date first, then company code 2000, then the currency, enter the header text,
After this, come to the bank data section. Here first you have to provide the bank incoming GL account number. Then the amount. Enter the tax. Now the assignment number. Then come to the open item selection section. Here enter the customer number. Then click on process open item. Now in this screen, come to this section. Here you can see the open invoices for customer. Double click and select this line item. Now you can see in this section the amount entered for payment and the amount assigned are same and the difference is zero. Simulate the entry. And then post. Now you can see the message that document is posted in the company code 2000. Now we will again execute the FBl5N report to see the payment document posted. Now enter the customer number. Then the company code. Then select the all item and enter the posting date from. And posting date to. Then execute. Here you can see the two documents with green status, which means it's clear, and we will double click to drill down the payment document which is created now to see the accounting entry for it. Now click on call up document overview. Here you can see the accounting entry for bank incoming, that is bank incoming ledger debit and customer receivable credit. Now go back to SAP menu using the T code slash N. Now I will post the bank outgoing payment and the T code uses F-53. Now in this section, enter the document date. Then company code 2000. Check the currency. Enter the document header text. After this, come to the bank data section. Here first you have to provide the bank outgoing GL account number. then the amount, enter the text, now the assignment number, then come to the open item selection section and enter the vendor number. Then click process open item. Now in this screen, come to this section. Here you can see open invoices for vendor. Double click and select this item. Now you can see in this section the amount entered for payment and the invoice amount assigned are same and the difference is zero. Simulate the entry to check for error. Then post. Now you can see the message that the document is posted in company code 2000. Now we will again execute the FBl1N report to see the payment document posted. Now enter the vendor number, then the company code, then select the all item and enter the posting date from. And posting date 2. Then execute. Here you can see the two documents with green status, which means it is cleared. And we will double click and drill down the payment document which is created now to see the accounting entry for it. Now click on column document overview. Here you can see the accounting entry for bank outgoing payment, that is vendor payable credit, and the bank outgoing ledger debit. Now go back to SAP menu.
Thank you for watching the video. Hope you found this informative. In my next video, I will explain the concept and accounting process of SAP bank reconciliation in S4 HANA. So if you are interested, kindly stay connected and subscribe the channel for the update on latest videos. Happy SAP learning.